A very interesting concept is to find out the profit percentage when the CP and SP values are given. Now, we all have learned this in school. The idea is to find it faster than before, right? So let me explain this using a sample question. Cost price is 1/2, selling price is 2/3, and you need to find out the profit percentage, right? So let's visit the learning that we had in school. Profit percentage is given by SP minus CP by CP into 100. Yes, the change in value divided by original value into 100. This is profit percentage, right? So how we used to calculate this? 2/3 minus 1/2 divided by 1/2 and into 100. Yes, so take the LCM here. In the numerator you get 6, so you have 4 minus 3 divided by 1/2 goes upward now into 2/1 and into 100. So this is simple solving. Yes, so what you get here is 100 divided by 3, that is equal to 33.33%. yes, so the formula that we have used here is SP minus CP divided by CP whole into 100. Now the problem here is when you have fractions, you need to take LCM, then find this change, then divide and multiply. So it takes a bit of time, right? Let me provide a twin concept to this concept that we have learnt in school. The same formula, let us write it down as profit percentage is equal to SP by CP minus 1 into 100. Now see, if you divide this SP by CP, CP by CP becomes 1, so you can write it as minus 1 whole into 100. Yes, now put the values. This becomes 2/3 divided by 1/2. Right, there's no need to take LCM here. This goes up, you get 4/3 minus 1 into 100, that is 100/3 is equal to 33.33%. Right, so for fractions, if you use this formula SP by CP minus 1 into 100, you will not be required to take the LCM and you reduce the step in your solving, which makes you faster than before. Now for solving in this style, you guys must remember ideally fraction to decimal to percentage conversion till 1/20. What I'm saying is 1/1 is 1, that is 100%. 1/2 is 0.5, 50%. Keep going. 1/3, 33.33%. 1/4, 25%. 1/5, 20%. 1/6, 16.67%. 1/7, 14.2857%. Right? Till 1/20, that is 5%, you should write down and memorize these values. This will benefit you in the entire arithmetic section as well as in the data interpretation section. I hope the concept is clear. Thank you.